School days?
Yes, please. I want to know about schooling. How was schooling? And
well, it was an Afrikaans school, but they obviously had an agreement with a mine that they would be English medium as well.
Okay.
And although when we got there, it was in the middle of the year, and I didn't know a word of Afrikaans. I was shoved into this Afrikaans class with all these children. And a teacher who hated the English. He hated the Catholics, the English. I mustn't tell you that. It's the poor man must be dead now anyway. And because I couldn't speak Afrikaans, he really gave me a hard time. He used to hit me on my ear with a pencil and but I never said a word to anybody. And which I suppose I learned Afrikaans within 2 months, 3 months I was speaking it.
Wow.
Very quickly.
Okay.
And in fact, at the end of that year, I don't know why he did it. He said, I must recite a poem, an Afrikaans poem.
Mm-hmm.
And it was called, now it's jumped right out of my head, but it starts like, Appel bloos kom om met spier witte manaar, dit is die rypert, die baasperts van my. It was an Afrikaans poem about a horse.
Yeah, yeah.
And after I'd finished, it was dead silence. And I looked at the teacher and he was going, and he said, it's the best rendition of that poem he's ever heard. So I thought, wow, this is a man that couldn't stand me.
Yeah.
But we used to call him Drak because he would think nothing of taking his belt off and slamming one of the boys,
yes.
You know, with his belt. And his wife was my sewing teacher. What a darling woman she was. She was such a lovely woman.
Mm.
I couldn't have children.
Okay.
And so they adopted a baby. And you know that saying, karma?
Mm.
And what is it? Kiddinki sa gebraai word? What is that saying? You know, it'll come back at you.
Yeah, it will come back.
Yeah, when the baby was about 4 or 5 months old, she started showing signs. She was a little colored child.
Oh, okay.
And we thought, it's God punishing him because he hates the blacks.
Yes.
And he wanted to give the baby back. They wouldn't. They,
and that was
they can't. Once you adopted a child, you can't give
it
back.
And that was still in apartheid years, hey?
Oh yeah.
So it was quite bad.
Actually, yes, it was. Was it that bad already in the 50s? I don't think so. I don't know.
No, that's before my time. You must tell me.
I don't know if it was that bad. I can remember going into a shop and there'd be blacks in there, and you know.
And they raised the baby then.
They must have, because.
Yes.
I mean, what can you do? At first I thought, well, it's God punishing him for being so horrible.
Yes.
But then on the other hand, how would he have treated that child? That's what worried me afterwards, you know.
No,
but shame now. I mustn't drag things like that up.
But tell me, how big was the school? How many learners were there?
We were quite a big school.
Is it?
I mean, there were about, 28, 29 in my class alone.
Wow.
And my brother... was in standard 5, there might have been as many in there. And then from standard 5, for me from standard 5 onwards, they split us up. They built asbestos, just 2 rooms.
Mm-hmm.
And one teacher took surveys of standard 1, standard 2, and Mrs. Rue, who was born and brought up in Jagersfontein, she was a Miss Clark, her father owned a shop, Clark's shop. I knew them all because I have later on I worked in the bank and I used to do a walk around every day, you know, to for a bill walk. I don't know if you know what a bill walk is.
Yes.
Go and get them to sign their bills.
Yeah.
And then Mrs. Fisser, Dorothy's mom, bought it from Mr. Clark and she was running it as a general store, you know. Not general, I don't think she had groceries. She had everything else.
Yes.